Hi everyone and welcome back. Now we are in the final phase of our tutorials where we are actually talking about the migrations and seeders. After that we will write one end-to-end applications like shopping cart kind of application where you will be able to add the car, add the product, you will be able to add the users, add the product, all these things will be there. So you are going to build one application which is having the multiple MySQL tables. They will be talking to each other, they will be getting the data from multiple tables. We will be storing the data into the multiple tables, right? So before going there, we need to understand how Sequelize associations we can write in the migrations and in the models. So let's go one by one. So first of all, we have already seen how Sequelize migrations runs. Now, first we will talk about these three things: user, task and context. So these are actually three MySQL tables we are talking about. So these are three schema models. First we'll try to define the associations between these three. Okay, even before that we need to understand how actually this works. So in any applications where you are actually using Sequelize, what you do? Till now we were just doing Sequelize.sync. If you remember the first video which I talked about, Sequelize.sync is taking care of everything. Now we are doing model.sequelize.sync because we have created a model folder or Sequelize init. Create a model folder with the index.js file. So this index.js files automatically gets created if you just do Sequelize init. Then, and what this JS file is doing? It is just reading all the model files and making them available in the DB object. So if you wanted to do a query, then you can do a query using models.user, not user.findAll. So you need to prefix models because this model object has all the schema models defined for the application. Okay, so earlier we were just doing writing some queries and doing Sequelize.sync, which automatically creating the tables. Same thing we are doing here, but here we are just making force equal to false because the tables we are going to create using migrations. The associations we are going to create using migrations. But now here, at two different places, we need to maintain the relationships and the key attributes. One is a model. This is the model we have, right? Here I need to maintain all the type keywords I have in the model like ID and email. And the associations, I have to define using associate method in the model. Associate user.hasManyContext means user has a one-to-many relationship with the context. Okay, and when you go to the context, it will say context has many user and context belong to user. So context has one-to-one relationship with the, one single context will represent a single user, but single user can have multiple context. So when we talk about user to context, it is a one-to-many, but when you talk about context to user, it is one-to-one. Okay, so we will be writing these migrations and the model class. So there are already some alternatives which you can use. Like there are special commands which you can just run to create migrations and models. I will just give you that migrations.generate, right? Similarly, you can just put model and generate. So it will just generate model customer.js model inside a customer folder. When you just say migration, then it will generate migration inside a migration folder. And when you hit Sequelize init, what it will do, it will create all the folders, models, config, seeders and migration folder for you. Okay, if they doesn't exist already. Now, so same definition. So first of all, we created this schema model. This is how we wanted to define our user. But how can we create it? You can create it either by just putting here server.js force equal to true. So what it will do, it will just drop the complete table and it will create that. But we will take care of that using migrations. So migrations are the special place where we will define the associations, and migrations are responsible for creating the entity in database. I mean, this is the right way. You can also do it with the just defining the schema model and just do the sync operation with the true option here. When you do true, it will actually drop out everything. So the old way of doing it, node server.js So first we need to drop, right? So what it is doing, drop table, if I exist, it has dropped the tables and it has created it, but we don't want it to do it. So if we do false operation, what it will do, so it will just try to create if doesn't exist, so it is not dropping anything. So in simple language is, we will do all these things with the migrations. Migrations will take care of create, update, or define associations, I mean the relationships between the tables. All these will be done by the migrations. These models will just define what kind of structure you are going to have, because these model objects will be responsible for fetching the data using query. Okay, so default we are getting index.js. Now when we read it, server.js, model.sequelize.sync, what it is doing, it is putting all these schema model object on the models object. Okay, it was, you can see that when we are running node server.js, it is doing a sync operation. So it, for now it is a force is false, so it is just reading it and it is making all the schema model object available on the models. So you can do a query models.user. Okay, but in real life what we will do, we will use migrations to create the table, change the column, alter the table, or define the associations. We will use the migration. So create user, we will use, so migrations, we already seen the syntax is how it is being done. We have up and down syntax. In the up, we just define the table structure. So up and down, there are two functions. Why, what is the use of down? Sometimes you want to undo the operation, right? So let's just sequelize db drop. So what it will do, it will drop the database. Similarly we can do create. Right now I can just run the migration, db migration, it's migrate. So it will run the db migration. If you wanted to do undo, so it will try to execute down part of all the migrations, right? So that is the importance of doing undo. So you can also test that whenever you do undo, is that change is being happening or not. Here in these migrations we have defined the data. I'll let the attributes like IDs, primary key, name, description, done. For task, for user, it is you can see the user columns, email and just ID. And here we can see the associations. Now let's see how we are defining the associations. So we have these three entities, user, task and context, right? So user has many context, so it's a one to many relationship between user and context. Single context will have one user only, so single context belongs to user. And context can have a, so context is like a project. User has a project, user can have multiple projects, multiple, single project can have multiple tasks. One project will belong to user only, and single task will belong to context. It should be context. Here I need to edit it. Task will belong to context. So there is a one-to-one relationship between a task and context. Context will have a multiple task, user will have a multiple context, one context will belong to one user. This is the theoretical relationship we talked about, right? Now when we try to simulate it, how we can do that? We need to look at our schema models. User has many context, that is fine. You can skip it or you can define these what is the foreign key and all, but this is the first argument, has many. Okay, similarly task go to the context. Context will have many tasks. First of all, context will have many tasks and context will belong to user. So just try to define these relationships in your brain and try to populate that here in the code. Now if you talk about task will be belongs to a context. Simply task will belong to context, right? Because context has a multiple task, but single task will belong to a particular context only. Similarly, like user has multiple context, but one single context will belong to one user. So it's like you need to define it in the both the way, that user has many context and single context belongs to one user, right? This is how we define associations in Sequelize. In the next video, we will run the migration and we will see what is happening and how we are able to query the database.